For a limited time only, head on over to MrMuttCoin.com and use code GS for 15% of all purchases. Not only can you purchase coins, you can purchase players, you can purchase training, you can sell coins for a little bit of extra bread. Who can use extra bread? You can get your solos done. You can pay to get your level grinded. You can sit back and relax and let someone do the dirty work for you. Go to the link in the description and make sure you click it and head on over to MrMuttCoin.com and use code GS for 15% off all your purchases. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Madden 20 video. GS here, and today we are going to show you guys the theme diamonds that I picked up and how they just look all juiced up with lockdown, pass rush, and Madden collectibles and all that fun stuff that we're able to add to the already pretty good attributes. So offensively, everything stays the same. I'm just focusing so much on defense right now because stopping the run, stopping passes, is all that stuff is not easy. So eventually I'm gonna be, you know, focusing more on my offense. The last thing I did was upgraded my entire offensive line, but little by little, like, I wanted Corey Dillon. I expressed that in the other video. There's definitely a handful of people that I definitely want for offense that, you know, now I feel like my defense is set. Outside of maybe one or two more players, all upgrades from here on out for the next about three or four are going to be just all offense, because right now my defense is exactly where I want it to be. So you see on the top right, we hit 90 overall, and we have, let's hit the B button one time, and we have a 91 overall defense. As far as I know, I'm the first person to do it. So if someone did it before me, I don't need you leaving in the comment section that Joey Blowy did it 2 weeks ago. I didn't see it. I'm the first one that I saw it, so I'm keeping the title. So 91 overall defense, and let's take a look at the players that we went ahead and got. First, you should see in the top left, my man Murtano Hankington. You guys knew I was bringing the Birdman home, the Nick Monster. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at Merton Hanks. Now, he does have lockdown maxed out. 87 speed. We're able to get that with Bruiser. I keep saying Bruiser. I get Bruiser and Brawler mixed up all the time. With Brawler maxed. Well, not maxed out, but I have tier 3. I have 22 out of 30. So I almost have Brawler maxed out where I can get plus 2 speed. But right now, he gets plus 1 speed and plus 2 strength from it. And he loses 1 Excel. And then when I get it maxed out, he's going to lose 1 agility. But again, a lot of people say, why that over Sprinter? Sprinter gives plus 2 speed and plus 2 Excel. And Brawler gives plus 2 speed and plus 2 strength. But on Sprinter, you lose 2 agility and 2 something else. I forgot what it was. Oh, 2 strength. You lose 2 strength and 2 agility. Where on Brawler, I still get the plus 2 speed, but I only lose 1 agility and 1 acceleration. I'd much rather lose 1 Excel and 1 agility than 2 agility and 2 strength. That's just me. But anyways, he has 92 zone. I know his hit power is fairly low, but, you know, let's be real. He's a coverage guy. So this is still Madden 20. He's definitely going to force some hit stick fumbles because that's how Madden is, because Dion will have 37 hit power, but he will still knock the ball loose in certain spots. But again, 87 speed, 6'2", 85 Excel, 80 tackle, 91 play rec, 83 man, 92 zone. Definitely had to scoop my man up. And he was actually one of the last persons that I went ahead and got. Then we also picked up Peanut Tillman, 6'2" cornerback. Now, he has lockdown maxed out, and I also have Madden pass defense maxed out, tier 2. So that is going to give me plus 1 man zone, power move, finesse move, and press to every single player on the team. So he actually has 90 zone, 88 man coverage. So this right here is good, because if you guys don't know, 90 zone and man, those are the beginning thresholds. And if you can get someone to 90, they're definitely going to play a lot better than someone with like 88 or 89. So if you can get someone to 90, definitely do your best to get someone to 90. Again, great height, 6'2". He's going to be a great zone coverage guy for me. And he is someone that I just expect to do great things in zone. So when I looked at all the diamonds, I was like, you know what? I really just want every corner there. I picked up 4 corners and 1 safety. And I have a total of 8 cornerbacks on my team that I will put in situationally, and I'll explain that in a bit. We also picked up Patrick Surtain. Look at my man Surtain right here. 89 speed, and we definitely have issues with not being able to have very good speed over the top in this game. And him having 89 speed makes him one of the fastest guys in the game right now for corner. 91 man, so he has great man, great press, great play rec. He doesn't have the best zone coverage, neither does Stephon Gilmore. And when I am in zone, I try to not have Gilmore or Surtain there because their zone coverage just isn't the best and they don't meet the threshold. Now, I'm in a position to where, you know, I've been getting a ton of coins by playing a lot of, just look at the squad's leaderboards. You see I lead the world in Super Bowls and I got a lot of wins. We play a lot, so the rewards are so good this year that I'm getting a lot of players simply off of just winning games online. Now, don't get me wrong. I definitely have purchased a handful of packs and bundles. But for the most part, most of the team has come from just winning a bunch of online games. And that right there, you know, allows me to get extra suited guys. You know, like someone in my stream asked me earlier today, twitch.tv/MrGoldenSports, by the way. Make sure you guys click that link in the description and hit that follow button if you did not already. That way, when I do go live, you get notified. Like, you know what? I can't do what you do, Nelson. You got 8 corners just for specific situations. What if I just want one guy for, like, man or one guy for zone? And I told him, okay, this is what you go for. This is going to help you out, you know. But for me, I got certain guys for man, certain guys for zone. So, like, when I run man, I want Gilmore, who has 96 man out there. I want Surtain, who has 91 man, 89 speed. And I'd rather have him in man coverage over Tillman. So let's say I just come out and dime, right? And I just want to run man for a play or two. Tillman is going to hit the bench, and I'm going to flood the coverage with very good man coverage guys. And when I'm on zone, Surtain, unless he's going to be user at safety because he has very good speed, I'm going to put Tillman and other zone guys. So Surtain and Tillman are going to be, you know, put in situationally. And then we picked up Renfro. Now, this card is on the field no matter what. On the field no matter what. 6 foot, 88 speed, 87 excel, 89 agility, 89 jumping, 89 play rec, 90 man, 91 zone, 79 press. So he doesn't have the best press. So that's one thing you have to look out for if you're doing like a lot of 3-4 pinch buck O or just a lot of pressing. He's not the best guy to press with. So you definitely want to try to match up by overall, because you do not want this guy on their best receiver, because their best receiver is probably going to have very good beat press and get off the line pretty good, and you don't want that. Like, you don't want him on someone that can just beat a press line like a Torrey Holt or Marvin Harrison. You want him on someone like their third receiver that he can probably just completely bag and lock down. Outside of his press, he is an absolute monster everywhere else. He's on the field at all time. Meets both thresholds, and there's not too many people that do that in this game. Chris McAllister, we picked up as well. 6'1", 91 man, 87 zone, 92 press, 91 play rec, 87 jump, 86 excel with a speed of 86. Now, again, I picked up 4 cornerbacks, and 2 are... Renfro is kind of like he can do it all. But out of the 4, Tillman is just going to be like a very good zone guy for me. McAllister and Patrick are going to be great for man coverage, and Renfro is just anywhere. So people ask, you know, what am I going to do with the cornerbacks that they're going to be replacing? So I decided to keep them, and I have 3 cornerbacks that are still on the team. So we go right. I'm still keeping Jalen Ramsey. I'm still keeping Sherman, and I'm still keeping Blunt for now. And the reason why I'm keeping all these guys is because, again, I can situationally add all these guys in. And let's say I come out in dollar, right? And in dollar, I can put safeties and cornerbacks everywhere. I can literally have an 8-field secondary with just 3 down linemen, because you can put 2 safeties at middle linebacker. And then all the other spots, I can put corners everywhere. So if that's the case, you know, Jalen Ramsey has the zone threshold, so does Sherman, and so does Blunt. I'm keeping Ramsey and Sherman the entire year. Whenever, and Patrick Peterson. I got to add Patrick Peterson as well. But Patrick Peterson is not going to be here. He's just going to be in my binder, because Patrick Peterson doesn't meet any threshold. He has good man. He has 88 man, but he's not nowhere near as good as the other guys that I have for those situations.
and his speed isn't the best right now compared to all the other guys I have. But whenever I get another cornerback, Mel Blunt, I'm probably going to power down and sell, because I'm not going to keep him throughout the year, because it's going to be a while before another legend, you know, before he gets another legend upgrade. It can literally be, there's some, like Alan Page, his base legend card, he didn't get last year another card until, what, Superstars or Blockbuster, whatever the promo was. It was months. So, like, once another corner comes, or I might just get rid of Blunt now. I'm deciding on it. I might just keep him. But let's say in dollar, I want to come out in just like a cover three zone, right? Let's say I know they're going to pass, and I just want zone coverage everywhere. So at the middle linebacker, I can put both Tillman and Ken Houston. They both have great speed, and they both can be used by me if in duos, or if I'm by myself, I can use a one-hook zone and have the other hook zone occupied by the CPU with great zone coverage. On the corners, on the outside, with great zone coverage, I can have Tillman, and I can have Renfro on the outside, right? And then there's like a few other spots that where I can plug in Ramsey, Sherman, and Blunt, and all of those guys are going to surpass the threshold in zone coverage. So I know situational and things like that, like I'm probably not going to use McAllister all game, or Tillman all game, or Surtain all game, but when the time comes, you know, depending on the offense you are providing me with, I should be able to have any type of passing offense you throw at me locked down, or at least checked for the most part, as long as I put the people in the right situations and do the right adjustments that I need to, we can do a pretty good job of hopefully stopping your pass. Running is a whole nother thing, because it's impossible to stop the run, at least for me. I try my best and it never works out. But 91 overall defense. We have goons all over the place. We have 5 theme diamonds added to the squad, and I cannot wait to get some head-to-head gameplay with you guys, which should be live tomorrow. So be on the lookout for that. Hopefully you guys enjoy, man. It's your boy GS. We're going to go ahead and be signing out, man. Appreciate the support as always. Make sure you guys head on over to MrMuckCoin.com and use code GS for a limited time only 15% off of everything. Whether you want coins, whether you want to sell coins, whether you want to purchase players, whether you want your solos done, whether you want to have your level grinded for you, code GS will take 15% off everything you want to purchase. See you guys next video. Appreciate the support as always.